lascia la figura in cascata da porto di me. In motivation was to explore in a deeply way the role of drugs to produce a novel fit. The point is, before we begin just using electrons, but it was not enough. And we had ions, to move ions to get flux, you need quite large voltage. In this experiment, we work up to a counter electrode of 1,200 volts, sinusoidal. To study the effect of only the voltage to stimulate flux, we make a step down about the previous experiment. In the previous experiment, we used geometry to promote non-equilibrium condition. Now we remove any thermal discontinuity and we just focus on voltage effect. So the time we developed a nose, cappuccino nose, and so on. So now the system is locally as homogeneous as possible. We identify only one parameter. The main is we want to understand the effect. So oversimplification is the only possibility. During the MIT conference, 6 months before, we explored the effect of electrons. So it means Richardson law, well-known to people, and the Child Langevin law about the movement of electrons. Later we realized it was not enough to have our wishing, so we explored the Paschen regime that Paschen developed about 150 years before, Germany, to study the insulation properties, high voltage insulation. So experiment made at room temperatures and DC condition. This experiment gives us a lot of quite important information how to manage the system to avoid that the chassis vanish over time. Moreover, we just study again the strange effect of spontaneous voltage, a current coming out from insulated wire put inside the reactor. And it was tested also from Machiavellate, Bob Gaines, some years before. The starting point of the effect of all, I think, anomalous heat generation seems quite easy. Just load as much as possible some proper material, palladium, titanium, nickel, or alloy, we use alloy, and after try to move it. Moreover, we observed, not only us, that some flux of electrons can help the effect. The main drawback, at least in our experiments, from a long time, that the beginning when you make some changes, you have anomalous heat. Later, almost always, all the chassis heat going to zero. So it means the equilibrium condition is zero power equilibrium. You have to move, you have to make non-equilibrium. And so the problem is we want something useful. We need continuous excitation, we need flux or something more, or damaging of material, something difficult to identify in some way. But the point is, if we have low loading to get working Richardson and Child and Patten regime. You need high temperature and low pressure. But we have got, it means you load the wire. So it seems no solution, no solution problem. And this is the main reason, because we concentrated at the Patten regime, because it allows to have some residual pressure, not really zero, very close to zero, like in the Richardson law, and you can work with some residual gas. We need the odor inside. And moreover, if we alternate between negative and positive voltage, we have also the electrons during the positive shape of the wave. We have a structure like an old diode, anode and cathode, with some residual gas inside the tube, the bubble tube. Not really bubble, some residual gas. Okay. This is the quite famous Patten law. So this is the product between pressure and distance, and cathode. It's the voltage necessary to have conduction. So reducing pressure at constant, the voltage is lower, it does start again. So this minimum is the operating point. Means if we have larger voltage, we can work at a larger pressure. Quite simple. This data was made in DC condition at room temperature. They made some other studies at low temperature and high temperature. Usually at high temperature we have some advantage. Before we concentrate about user nodes, because the nodes don't need energy to have non-equilibrium, but they have some limits. So now we just forgot for the moment nodes and go over. We just use the same constant because at the peculiarity to generate a dissociation of hydrogen to the from molecular to atomic state, very, very easy. It's the best material for this purpose. And moreover, the hydrogen to the is stored inside the constant itself. So it's like local, every million of reactor where you can make the reaction. At a point we observe that as the wire is thinner, as the result are better. So a simple explanation is just geometry. If we have, because the thickness of a sponge almost constant, 10, 20, 20, 20 micron, the ratio between the bulk, very low activity, and the surface increase reducing the wire diameter. Quite simple relation. To make a sponge, before used very high pulse, up to 10-20,000 amperes per square centimeter, repeated several hundred times. But now use more simple just for check. Anyway, the using the pulse is the best way, even time consuming. And moreover, the wire is covered from specific materials like iron that helps for the reaction, strontium because it's a lower emission material, and potassium and manganese. Potassium is cofactor, and manganese reduces the evaporation of potassium. Moreover, it is a multi-layer approach, so several layers of 10, 100 nanometers each other. At the points we need atomic hydrogen source locally, and we use the glassy, some glassy as the peculiarity to solve atomic hydrogen and the not molecular. It was found from Langmuir in 1928. So at the point is a thermoiodic emission, Richardson law is the well-known Richardson formula, and it depends upon working function of the material. We selected the low working function material. It is a graph how the current at the surface of the cathode change using changing the temperature on or the work function. So the changing is really giant. The people that first developed a low working French material was Iwamura in 1986, more or less. But at the low temperature. Now, very, very fast about the Capuchin geometry. The Capuchin node has the peculiarity to have local thermal gradients without adding energy, but the main limitation is the number of nodes you can make and easy to break. Here is the local temperature, it's a true photo. So you have 300-400 degrees difference in a few millimeter distance. Yes, some aspects are really ideal, but later we make a more sophisticated way to increase the number of nodes of turning, and we have to put some insulating layer, and we develop a new kind of glassy sheet made of two materials in the same sheet altogether. Thanks to collaboration of CG company, France Italy, and the Italian company that helped us from 8 years, but some budget and several technical suggestions. So it was a practical advantage for everybody. Okay, so I try to. This is the sketch of the reactor. We have 3 reactors on each tube, always constant, so we can compare the data, changing just the kind of core, but the geometry is always the same. Here's a sketch of the super cappuccino geometry, quite complicated, sophisticated, but now we forget for the moment. The energy balance is made by airflow calorimetry, very, very simple. Input output in the same height, just crossing to increase turbulent air. Very, very simple. Nothing special. Here is a sketch photo of the reactor before mounting the 3 wires, the 3 cores. In the tray of the reactor inside the insulating box before closing. And moreover, to have homogeneity respect to the calibration, we put aluminium foil thick black net to have a more homogeneous temperature. Now, the new one, this is the new geometry, is a sort of several coaxial geometry. it's really not easy to to understand. So just give key points, after you can read in your from the presentation. It's a sort of coaxial. The inner is the counter electrode made of iron, insulating sheet, acting wires put inside the insulating sheet, cast on the white side or platinum, and over insulating thermal insulation and reflecting for insulating. So in this way, we can have a large temperature up to 800 and 900 degrees with enough low power. Here, these are schematic of some auxiliary circuitry, because we use very large voltage and several times we have damage of the electronics. Here, sketch about the three wires, all the same, platinum, constantan, 200 microns, constantan 50 microns. This is the auxiliary circuit to measure the incident ratio of the wires and the protection network, self-protection network. And this is the simple oscillator we built to have a sinusoidal wave up to 600 volts, just using the main, and we measured the current flowing at the counter electrode through this resistor, voltage and the current. Some typical result. This is what happens with the counter electrode when the pulse, even present, is not absorbed from active wire. So you have almost the same voltage in and out of the resistance. No effect. Okay, you give power, nothing happens. This is an intermediate regime, so the temperature is high to have a Richardson effect, but the pressure was too low. We intentionally reduced as much as possible the pressure. So we have symmetric current, the Richardson law means electrons and ions, quite similar. There is some effect, but it was weak. The third one is the best regime, and this is the regime that gives the most advantage. In this measurement, we have the largest chassis stable over time. There is 40 watts. These high frequency components, very, very difficult to identify the components, is the key point. Try this, okay, sure. This is the key. We need this kind of regime. So more or less at the minimum of the Pascal curve. In this study, at the room temperature, we studied the pressure needed in our case to have a Pascal regime, and the local thermometer in this temperature when we started maximum of the absorption, so correlation, compared to correlation. When the pressure was too low, nothing happened. So we are confident that we don't make mistakes. in this experiment, the wire temperature was about 700 degrees, in parallel 80 watts, and we get excess heat stable about 11 watts until we change a little bit the parameters to check about resistance. So we have the loading of the wires and the chassis decreased but still active, 80 watts, so more than 10%. So it's very, very critical. The window of operating is very, very narrow. And is the best result, a mixture of argon and deuterium. The argon has the lower voltage for the Pascal regime, so it makes effort. The pressure just 50 millibar, and we get about 14 watt stable. These are the results about anomalous voltage. In each conference we show data more or less similar, so the effect is reproducible. Till now we don't really understand what is going on anyway. It's very, very reproducible. Anybody can do. Conclusion. The point is, to get anomalous heat is very, very difficult. We think we need artificial intelligence to follow the maximum of the system and calibrate voltage and pressure. So my brain now is a bit tired to follow the maximum. In perspective, now computer has a cost very low. Other easy point to increase the voltage from 1,200 to 3,000-4,000. We have a larger regime where we can work. Maybe increasing voltage is more easy, more cheaper than artificial intelligence and software. Some possible explanation why we don't have a decrease of performance. One is flux that we think at the beginning. Another, in our regime, we have like a cold plasma. The cold plasma means the surface of material always catalytic. They don't die, young forever. And then we think we have both effects. In the next step, we'll use again a special geometry to increase non-equilibrium condition. And putting all together, will be the event when the cold fusion, I call it, will be practical, is not too far from the time. Thanks.
And now your questions, please.
Question about I have a question about the temperature dependence. So in some reports last year, it was claimed that there is exponential dependence of the excess heat on temperature. Did you measure anything similar?
Yeah. Yes. I agree. So because exponential dependence, we think it's due to electron component. But the Pascal curve is no strong dependence about temperature. But because both works, so and we need electrons, so the exponential component is okay. We confirm the data.
It's nice to see the constant progression and ideas in your work, Francesca. Just very simply, are you saying that every day of the week you can achieve 14% excess heat?
Sorry.
Are you saying that every single time you can achieve 14% excess heat
Okay. If we give excitation from the beginning, from room temperature, always keep there, the material is active. If we give excitation when it is high temperature, the system has a lower performance. So means the state of the surface, the catalytic properties are key parameters. In people that make sputtering know very well this point. I was surprised that I'm not sputtering people. Say, okay, it's normal. Why so strange? Oh, okay, thanks. Confirmation. Yes.
I have a personal message to pass on you. If anybody wants to replicate Francesco's experiment, I think there is no problem with you. We can supply an FMP has available replica cells of Celani. So if you want to try, you can try it at almost no cost. We ship you the cell, you have the wire from Celani, and you can try it out by yourself.
This is one of the core of the reactor that my colleagues make very, very gently. Usually, unit construction is broken because of tight. That I can show to everybody.
A few years ago, you made experience with hydrogen, pure hydrogen, yes. Not deuterium, and now you are
good.
On the
nice question. The point is, if we work with hydrogen, in that moment with deuterium, we can have some time where we get nothing. And after start again. So I have a tank of deuterium. I decide to work with the deuterium until the bottle is full. And then I go back again with hydrogen. Because I have no time to optimization.
Okay.
Thanks for your time.
The next speaker is Jacques Ruhrer with his presentation, Basics of Airflow Calorimetry.